Yesterday, major flood warnings were issued for two rivers here in Gippsland, the Mitchell River just behind me and the Avon River in Stratford. Both rivers increased to over 6 metres in height, but luckily no homes were affected as a result of the floodwaters. The SES received over 310 calls for help, including 14 rescue call-outs. Five of those were people just north of here in the town of Wukwuk who drove into floodwaters and found their car really quickly became submerged. We understand they had to get out onto the roof of their car and cling onto trees while they waited for the SES to arrive and rescue them. Today, the concern is that high winds have been forecast, and with so much rainfall across this area, the ground is extremely soft, and that could see trees come down very, very easily. The SES are on alert to clean up any trees that might come over, and they are reminding people to be cautious of fallen trees or trees that bring down power lines, and not to drive through any floodwaters that might be on the road.
Well, meanwhile, in New South Wales, residents in the state's central western town of Forbes are on standby for major flooding after days of heavy rain. The Lachlan River is expected to peak on Monday and is threatening similar levels to the disastrous 2016 floods. Moderate flooding has already hit Cowra and Nanami, and the state emergency service crews are helping with sandbagging in the region. Ben Pickup is the New South Wales SES Southern Zone Commander. He says communities must prepare for a potential evacuation.
On Sunday night, we're likely to see the communities around Nanami and Gullagong impacted by floodwater. There's potential for a peak of 12.3 metres there late Sunday evening. We shouldn't see the impacts that we'll see at Forbes, though. There's a lot of rural communities and a large floodplain for the water to spread out on. We see during floods, we see a lot of people drive through flooded roads, and we continue to undertake flood rescues. So just encourage people not to drive, walk or ride through floodwater. You put your own life at risk, as well as the rescuers who come to provide assistance. Follow all warnings from the emergency services. If they are asked to evacuate, they need to evacuate. And ensure if they need any assistance, they call 132 500.